great are you?
One of a kind.
One of the few movies that I have liked for as long as I can remember is the animated classic Shrek. Although it's better remembered for its colorful characters, soundtrack, and the insane amount of Shrek-themed products that were out in the early 2000s, I believe its biggest strength is how it brings Shrek on a simple but believable arc. I'm Evan Westman, and this is an interior analysis of Shrek. One could argue that most good stories are about people going through a period of great change. A lot of what makes an ending satisfying is the feeling that a meaningful change has taken place from the start to the end of a story. Sometimes a character's arc of change is blatant.
Scudder and the power of self-respect.
Sometimes it's subtle. Sometimes the point is that the characters don't change, either for good or for bad. And all too often, a movie will add in a couple of moments that are meant to feel emotionally cathartic, but don't actually signal any meaningful growth for the character. Shrek is an example of a positive change arc that is both simple and organic. Shrek's starting belief is that he is better off alone, and his ending belief is that he can love and be loved. I've heard many terms used to describe the start or end points of a character's arc, like want versus need, orphan state, tolerable imperfection, the lie they believe, or facade and true self. These are all useful terms, but for simplicity, I'm just going to refer to them as starting and ending beliefs. So how does the story organically bring about such an extreme change in Shrek in just 80 minutes of runtime? First, let's look at how the world of the story reinforces Shrek's starting belief.
People take one look at me and go, "Ah, help! Run! A big, stupid, ugly ogre!" They judge me before they even know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
By the time we hear Shrek state this about halfway through the movie, we've already been shown that it is true. The outside world is actively hostile towards Shrek and views him as inherently dangerous. It's a world that will never accept him and still hasn't by the end of the movie.
Really, it's rude enough being alive when no one wants you.
And playing into these stereotypes keeps him safe. Because of all this, there is little incentive for Shrek to change. So it's up to the supporting characters to prove to Shrek that not everyone will treat him like this.
I'm an ogre! You know, grab your torch and pitchforks! Doesn't that bother you?
Nope!
Donkey gives Shrek his first indication that maybe there are people in the world who won't treat him with such extreme prejudice. When Fiona meets Shrek, she treats him about the same as everyone else, but soon shows that she was also willing to give Shrek a chance. But introducing less prejudiced people into his life isn't enough to convince Shrek to break his antisocial habits. This is why the events of the story are designed to challenge Shrek's beliefs. Each event in the story presents Shrek with choices that give him an opportunity to act more in accordance with either his starting or ending belief. Let's quickly run through the major choices that Shrek is presented with. At the beginning, the world is rejecting Shrek, so he chooses to close himself off. When Donkey runs into Shrek and shows that he doesn't care about Shrek's ogreness, Shrek allows him to stay. But when Shrek's swamp suddenly becomes a refugee camp, Shrek decides to put an end to his hospitality and goes to Lord Farquaad. After a baller fight scene, Farquaad offers to remove the fairy tale creatures if Shrek rescues Fiona for him. Once they rescue Fiona and she is turned off by Shrek's ogreness, Shrek chooses to play into her expectations. But when Fiona proves that she is more accepting than other humans, Shrek responds in kind by opening up and putting aside his own assumptions about her. However, when he overhears Fiona and Donkey confirm his fears of never being accepted, he pushes them away and goes back to shutting out the rest of the world. When Donkey returns and fills him in on what he missed, Shrek's hopes are reignited, and he goes all in on telling Fiona that he loves her. Some of these choices don't have huge or immediate impacts on the external events of the story, but without these opportunities to test his new and old beliefs, the external events would be meaningless, and Shrek's change might not be believable or even existent. Every character is different, and their arcs will look different from each other. But most good arcs are created by combining the story world, minor characters, and events of the plot so that they all impact the protagonist's beliefs. Creating these elements and finding the right combination of them for your own unique protagonist can be a challenging process, but I've found that crafting all of them in relation to my protagonist is a great thing to strive for. It can at least get me moving in the right direction, and works with most structure models without relying on them too much. By crafting the world of the story and the minor characters to create events that force Shrek to confront the beliefs that he's always held, the story is able to bring Shrek on a simple, believable, and complete positive change arc. The result is a thematically charged story filled with iconic characters that can stand the test of time. Hey everyone, thanks for watching this. If you want more analysis on Shrek, we did a podcast about it a few months back, so the link for that is in the description. Interior Analysis also has a Patreon now, so you can go and support us there and get access to some bonus content. Let us know what movies you want us to cover in the comments, and we'll see you next time.